Morning girls, today we learn English language, analyze sentence, okay, pay attention all of you girls, analyze sentence. To analyze a simple sentence, we divide a sentence into subject and predicate. Now, you are learning this from small standard, subject and predicate, but pay attention now. In detail, this is subject and predicate. First sentence, birds chirp. Second, here we have divided first one, birds chirp, birds subject, chirp predicate. I'll put this line. The boy sang a song. The boy subject, sang a song predicate. Next one, a rolling stone gathers no moss. A rolling stone subject, gathers no moss predicate. My little daughter loves to play with her dolls. My little daughter, subject, loves to play with her dolls. Now, in the first sentence, subject consists of one word, and that is birds, noun. This is noun, the first, only one subject word, and that is birds, and that is noun. In the second sentence, subject consists of two words. See, the boy. This is noun and subject consists of two words. In the first, it consists of only one and this is noun. Here, this is noun and it consists of two words. And in the third sentence, there are three. My little daughter. Okay. That is three words and this is noun. And see the fourth one. So this is the third one, a rolling stone. It consists of three words and this is noun. Fourth one, my little daughter loves to play with her dolls. It consists again of three and this is noun. So, what we have done in these sentences, we have divided the sentence into subject and predicate, and we have seen sometimes it consists only of one word, sometimes two, and sometimes it is three. Right? Now we have seen subject. Now pay attention to this. In first sentence, predicate is one word, right? That is chirp. Predicate is only one word. In the second, predicate is two words, that is sang or song, okay? Third, predicate is three words, and the last sentence, that is my little daughter loves to play with her doll, loves to play with her doll, that has got six words. So what we are showing in these sentences, first we divided the sentence into subject and predicate, then we are pointing out how many subject words are there and how many predicate words, okay, and the main noun you have to find out in the subject. When subject consists of several words, when subject consists of several words, there is one word important and that important word is called subject word. Look at this example, I'll show you what I am saying this, that when subject consists of several words, one word is important and that important word is called subject word. Look at that sentence now. The little child, tired of play, is sleeping. And here, the important word is child. In this, the subject, the little child, this is subject, the little child. Till here it is subject, and in this subject word the important word is child, and this important word is called subject word. This is noun. Okay, this child is noun. Now the subject word is qualified by an adjective. The subject word we said is child, and that is qualified by an adjective. When it is qualified by an adjective, it is called attribute. This is important. Attribute qualified. This noun, we found out that important word in a subject is child. Important word in a subject is called subject word, and we found out that is child. And this child is qualified by an adjective. When it is qualified by an adjective, that word is called attribute. Okay, that is little. It is describing the child, little. So this is attribute. Now see some more examples. Now see this sentence. New brooms sweep clean. We have divided this. This is subject, and we know sweep clean is predicate. Barking dog seldom bites. We have divided. This is subject, and this is predicate. Hari's father is an engineer. This is subject, and this is predicate. Now, in the first sentence, attribute is new. You know that subject word is broom. Okay, this is noun, this is subject word, and new is attribute, that is adjective. In the first sentence, attribute is adjective. In the second sentence, attribute is participle. This barking, it is participle, and this is attribute. And in the third sentence, Hari's, this is noun, this is attribute, Hari's father, right? Now here I have written this, what I have just said. In the first sentence, the attribute is an adjective. In the second, the attribute is participle. And in the third sentence, the attribute is noun. You have to understand, children, that when we divide the sentence into subject and predicate, we have to find out the important word, and that important word is subject word, and when it describes, that is attribute. And we have found out in this sentences attribute. Now, pick out complete subject, subject word, and attribute. In these sentences, we will find out, first we'll find out subject, then we'll find out subject word and attribute, which I have just finished explaining. For example, the first sentence we'll read, a burnt child dreads the fire. We divided, first we found out subject. This is subject. Okay. Then in the second one, my views, I'll continue with that subject word and attribute. First I'm just telling you, divided into subject. My views are quite different. This are divided into subject. Right. Now in the first sentence, burnt child. So this is attribute. We said, no, we find out first subject, then subject word and attribute. So first one, this is attribute, and the subject word is child. You know this. This is noun, subject word, important. This is subject word, this is attribute, and this is subject. I'm sure you understood. We have to find out three things. First, subject, subject word, and attribute. So this we divided. This is subject. This is subject word, important word, noun, and this is attribute. Next, my views are quite different. Okay, as we just said, this is subject. Next is, this is subject word. Okay, view. This is subject word and my is attribute and this is not adjective just this time. It is possessive adjective. Okay? My. So this is possessive adjective. And in attribute also please note a and the are also attributes. Okay? A and the are attributes. Have you understood this well? Subject, subject word and attribute. Now girls, listen to this. When predicate has only one word, that word is always verb. Okay, as we said before that, we said birds chirp. So chirp. Now I have written dogs bark. So when predicate has only one word, this is predicate, this is subject. So when it has only one word, it is always verb. When predicate has many words, the essential word is always verb. Maybe in a sentence as we have just done, predicate may be many words, but the essential word in predicate is always verb. Remember these. I'll repeat once again. When predicate has only one word, okay, that is dogs bark, so this is predicate, it is always verb. And when predicate has many words, the essential word is always verb in a predicate. Pay attention to these sentences here. The flames spread everywhere. He went home. The boy ran a mile. New broom sweep clean. Okay, first we divide it. Subject, predicate. Subject, this is predicate. This is subject. And this is subject. The rest here is predicate. Now look at this table I have written down. Subject, predicate. This line here, this side, that is subject, word and attribute, is subject, and verb and extension I have divided into predicate. In the first sentence, the flames spread everywhere. Subject word is flames. Okay, the main word in subject, flames. So that is subject word. Attribute is the verb. Spread and extension everywhere. Right? We are dividing the sentences, analyzing the sentence. Second one, he went home. So, he is subject, word, important, subject word. Here, there is no attribute. Went is verb and home extension. Number three, the boy ran a mile. Boy is subject word. The is attribute. Ran, verb. Ran is verb and a mile extension. Next, new broom sweep well. Brooms, it is a subject word. Brooms, subject word. New is attribute. And verb sweep, clean is extension. I am sure you have understood well how we have to first divide the subject and predicate or sentence. We divide it into subject and predicate, and then in detail we are finding out subject word, an important subject. Then we find out the attribute. We find out verb in a sentence and extension, the rest what is saying about the predicate. Today girls, you will revise what I have done and I will continue this next class. Please first revise this today what I have done. You will find easy when I continue. God bless you.